Major Andrew Fox, who I have to tell you, Beverly has a crush on. Didn't know you knew
that
Major Fox.
That's not fair, Andrew. Just to be clear, Andrew, after our interview yesterday, I said that was the very manly Andrew Fox. I'm sure you weren't offended by that, were you?
Andrew Fox, why was General Jackson such an inspirational leader?
Well, I think it was the sheer ability he had to make people feel involved with everything he was leading. It's, you know, he was an officer of tremendous wit and tremendous intelligence, an absolutely fearsome man at holding subordinates to account when they didn't meet his exceptionally high standards. But he had that ability that all the best leaders have to speak to soldiers and listen to what they have to say to him. And he was renowned as excellent company in the officer's mess. The soldiers loved him. And obviously he had a military track record that, you know, most people joining the army could only possibly dream of.
Household name to most people may not have heard of Mike Jackson, but obviously during the Iraq War 2003-06 played a really critical role for us.
Yes, and even so, even more so in Kosovo, where famously he refused to start World War III on behalf of General Clark, who was trying to get him to block the runway to Russian resupply at the airports. And you know, he was a man who would take a moral stand where he thought it was appropriate, and we saw that in his retirement as well, when he spoke up very clearly and very loudly about better conditions for soldiers, better pay, and better equipment. So this was a guy who cared about his troops, and who invested in them, and who made them feel, you know, worthy and worthwhile. And that's the real skill of a great leader.
He was good on the media too. I know that's probably not so important, but he had a very good profile on the media, didn't he, Andrew?
Yeah, and he had the wit and intelligence to get his point across in a way that connected with people. A great example from a mess dinner where he was giving a speech, and at the back someone was making crow noises, and a crow in the army is a junior person. And obviously everyone was looking around as who would dare to do this, and there were two veterans from Arnhem, you know, the Battle of Arnhem in 1944, where we're making crow noises. General Jackson, and he turned around and said, "Well, I suppose you can even reach the chief of the defense staff, but you're still a crow to somebody." And I grabbed the voice he had. And, you know, and that was the kind of wit and charm he brought to what he did.
Are there still men like that in the British Army in these woke times? Do you still get that sort of leadership, do you think?
Yes, I think so. I mean, I know some great leaders in the army, and yes, it's a more compassionate army than it has been in the past, but that's not necessarily a bad thing. As long as it comes to the crunch time, you've got warriors who will take men and women into battle and deliver the results that are needed. And I know plenty of people still in the army who are capable of that.